know what I thought of? I go to the movies every week, so I have to tell you guys what I think. I am back to do another movie review. The movie that I just recently went to go see. If you love action, then this is a movie that you need to see. It is so good, you guys. I'm telling you. New Year's Day. I hope everybody had a safe and fun New Year's Eve. I'm going to count down my 10 favorite movies of 2021. And to do that, I had to wear my favorite nails of 2021 and my favorite dress of 2021. So I'm going to start with number 10 is going to be Luca. Luca is a Disney movie about a boy that lives in the water, a mermaid, a mer boy. And when he comes to land, he turns human. Now, the thing about this is that the whole movie, if they get wet by water, they immediately turn back into being a mer boy. It kind of reminds me of Splash with Tom Hanks. You drop some water on her, they turn back into their original form. But what I liked about Luca is that even though it showed you that even though you may be different and some people may not like you, then there's a lot of people that will like you. So always stand in your truth and be who you are. I like Luca so much, my son dressed up as Luca for Halloween. Now, in retrospect, I don't think it was a good idea. I know he loved Luca, but he was walking around with this thing on, looked like he had on a leotard or something. I don't know if I would ever do that again with the mask, the whole one body, the whole one piece suit, you know, the full body. I don't know if I would do that again, but that's how much I loved Luca. Now, coming in at number 9 is going to be Without Remorse. I mean, Michael B. Jordan really can do no wrong. I really do think he can do no wrong. Seeing him come from Creed and all these other movies, like, I believe the first time I seen him was in Fruitvale Station. No, matter of fact, the first time I seen him is in Hardball, that movie with Keanu Reeves back in the day. So he's definitely done a glow up. But anyway, seeing him do so many different type of roles, what I liked about Without Remorse is that not only is it a novel by Tom Clancy that was made into movies, is the fact that he was able to get Lauren London into this movie. It hadn't been a long time since her boyfriend Nipsey Hussle had passed away, and she didn't want to go back to acting. But you know what? Michael B. Jordan really wanted her on this movie, so he had a conversation with her. He was able to convince her to start acting again, and that was in this movie Without Remorse. And at number 8 is going to be Dear Evan Hansen. And if anybody knows me, they know I was so touched by this movie. This is a movie that turned from novel to Broadway musical to a movie, which it was deserving of, because this movie is such a good movie. It talks about how this boy committed suicide, and the last person he talked to, everybody thought he was his best friend. So to not let the family down, he went ahead and acted like he was his best friend. And then at the end, just like I said, kind of with Luca, you have to live in your truth. So at the end, when you're piling up lie after lie after lie, it feels so good sometimes to tell the truth, even though it may hurt others. You got to sometimes be able to look at yourself in the mirror. So he finally had to tell his truth. And even though the walls came crashing down on him, the fact that he became a better person and he was able to stand in his truth. Dear Evan Hansen, that is one you definitely have to check out. Now, coming in at number 7 is going to be King Richard. Now, what can I say about this except that I grew up, if you look at my daughter's hair, I grew up seeing Venus and Serena Williams. I mean, the little beads, I did my daughter Kennedy's hair just like that. So I never knew a lot about them. All I knew is that they were from Compton, you know, and here are these black young ladies, you know, giving people the blues on the tennis courts. And that's what I loved about it. But I never knew the backstory of them. I never knew how hard he worked to get his children on there. And that's their dad, Richard Williams. He did everything he can to make sure that his kids were somebody, even though he said this world never treated him like he was somebody. The perfect person to play him was Will Smith. And together, this movie just, it is such a tearjerker, but it's also something that gives you encouragement. It motivates you, and it lets you know don't you ever give up on something that you know in your heart that you can do. And you know what? you will definitely prosper from that. And that's what I learned about this movie. And I think every person should watch it. All these movies I think everybody should watch, of course. But I definitely like King Richard. Number six is my only entry from Netflix, and it is a drama, and it is called Passing. A lot of people, I don't know if they saw it, but a lot of people, I think, slept on this movie. This movie is about a black woman, a fair-skinned black woman in the 1950s that was passing for white. And she runs into a friend that she went to school with that was high yellow, is what we call them, yellow, high yellow. And she passed for white only sometimes, but her friend was living a full out lie. She was living as a white woman. How does that happen? I don't know. If you have children, sometimes those genes are gonna pop out in different places. Yeah, she may come out with some blonde hair because your husband is white, but she might come out with that bell pepper nose, you know, that we have sometimes, that trademark. So you just have to see this movie. I can't tell you much about this movie anymore about it, but all I know is that if you're living in a world and you can't be who you are, if you're living like someone that you know you're not, which is back then, it wasn't no ancestor.com or no DNA or no 123 and this and that. It was none of that. You were either white or you were black. But now we have our, you know, we're mixed with so many different things and we look so different. It is hard to tell sometimes what a person is, but you always, always have to live in your truth. Or you know what? You'd be depressed if you're not the person you're supposed to be. So Passing is my number six movie. Coming in at number five is going to be Cruella. Now, at first, I kept saying, I don't want to see no Cruella. I do not want to see nothing about 101 Dalmatians. But this is a story of how Cruella grew up. And it gives you such a good backstory of how she became this person. This story is written very, very well. I was a little upset that I wasted so long to see Cruella. After seeing this movie, it shows you everything about how she was raised, how she was brought up, how she had to fight for everything, how people were stealing her ideas, you know, and it's just a wonderful movie. It doesn't make her the villain like we see her in the cartoons 101 Dalmatians. It doesn't make her the villain because we're so used to seeing her, you know, like the mean woman with the two-tone hair and this and that, and she's trying to kill some puppies. But in this movie, it gives her a voice. She is a human behind the villain. And sometimes we all get caught up when things are going well for us or when we may have some money or feeling really good. I wouldn't know nothing about that. But anyway, sometimes you do change the person that you are. But this starts from when she is a child growing up and the person that she is. And I really think that this is a good movie because I really was surprised at how good it was and how many twists and turns that Cruella took. I actually can't wait for a sequel to Cruella because it kind of left it open like that. And I just think this is a wonderful movie. At number four is my favorite movie. You have to understand, a lot of these movies on my top 10 are going to be family-friendly movies because I love kids. I got four kids. I got to go to the movies all the time with my 8-year-old, and I got to monitor what they're looking at. So coming in at number four is Clifford the Big Red Dog. I love that movie. I love the comedy in it. I love the interaction between Clifford and then each other. It reminds me exactly like Emily Elizabeth that was actually in the PBS TV show. They did such a good job of that. And then you have all these special appearances. You have Paul Rodriguez. You have, what is her name? The one that used to dance on Soul Train. I can't think of her name right now. But anyway, you have her. You have her. You have Kenan Thomas. You have such a big cast of people that came for Rosie Perez is her name. Don't you hate me? You can't remember something. I'm like, I'm not about to start this again. Her name is Rosie Perez. But anyway, yes, you had such a good group of people, a group of comedians coming in to do this movie. And the interaction between each other reminded me exactly of what I saw. Clifford is such a good family-friendly movie. I know you guys have heard me talk about it all the time. And that is Clifford. Now, coming in at number three is going to be Sing Part 2. I did not do a review for this because I had to run out and see it right away on Christmas. And Sing 2 is the bomb. I can't think of no technical word but say the bomb. If you've seen Sing 1, Sing 2 lives up to its predecessor, which is Sing 1, because it is wonderful. It has all the latest music, and then to see the cartoon animal characters do their music, I mean, with Matthew McConaughey playing, you know, Mr. Moon, I mean, that's the best part. I actually visualize these people as characters, because Mr. Moon is perfect in this movie. He is a person that, you know, never gives up. He never quits. He fights for a show, and that's what I love about this movie. I love Sing 2. You have to go see Sing 2, because you know what? It's going to make you sing. When you're in there watching the movie, you're going to sing along with them, because it's all the latest songs. And me and my son and my daughters were in there singing all these songs from this movie, because I really did like Sing Part 2. Now, before I get into my last two, I want to take this time, of course, to say happy birthday to a very special young lady in my life. That would be my daughter, Kennedy. Kennedy is such a wonderful young lady and human being, a smart, smart woman, that if it wasn't for her, I wouldn't even be standing in front of you guys right now. She always told me, I mean, it's so funny, I'm talking about her as if she's older, but she's always been such a good, smart kid. And, you know, she encouraged me to go ahead and do this, even though I felt a little bit out of touch, you know, with, oh, well, you know, times are different, times have changed, I don't know if I can do it. You know what, mama, just be yourself, and I'm sure people will like you. Some may not like you, but that's okay, but it is going to be some that like you. And teaching me how to edit, to do everything. Let me tell you something. One Saturday, that girl took 3 hours to show me how to work TikTok. I didn't even know how to work TikTok. I didn't know how to post. I didn't know how to hashtag. I didn't know how to do anything, cut my videos, anything. And it was my daughter that showed me. You know, you always think that your child is wonderful and special and the whole world should know. But with Kennedy, the whole world does know. They can see how special she is. She has so many offers since she's been in ninth grade, because she's gotten straight A's her whole life. I'm serious. I mean, in third grade, I mean, she was on the front page of the Las Vegas newspaper with Obama. You will never forget my daughter. She was on the front page, and I knew from right there that my daughter was destined to greatness. And she has done nothing but prove that. If you check out her TikTok, I mean, the last video she posted, she got, I think it's 248.K. You know, people watching it. I mean, she just, it's effortless for her. And I'm just so happy and proud of her. It definitely is the meaning of the golden child, because I believe that she is a very, very special child. And if she wasn't with me the whole time after I had that C-section, I might have thought she was like a doctor or lawyer's child. But yes, she is my child. And she is so creative. I mean, she does my hair. You know, she knows how to do nails, but doesn't really have time to do them. And I just think she has so much in her to show this world. And I'm just can't tell you how proud I am. I try not to be so braggadocious, but I'm definitely, definitely proud of my daughter who just turned 18. I love you to death, Kennedy. You already know that. You're kind of like my bestie. You're not kind of, you are my bestie. You're like my therapist, and I love that. You ever have a kid you just sit me telling stuff to? That's been my Kennedy since she's been a little girl. So happy birthday to you. Now, going in at number two. Boy, this was a tough one. My number two and my number one were tough. They're both Marvel movies, but one of them I had to put at number one as my favorite movie. And the one for number two, I had to bump down for other reasons. Coming in at number two is Spider-Man No Way Home. Yes, this movie is beautiful. This movie is amazing. This movie is funny. It is it's touching. It's heartfelt. It's adventurous. It's going to give you so many different emotions. And that's what movies are supposed to do. So many different feelings and emotions about this. This is the best sequel through Marvel as a Spider-Man franchise I have ever seen. Tom Holland definitely has all the credit of holding this movie together with his acting ability. He stands out of the crowd with this Spider-Man. And of course, yes, we have Tobey Maguire. Yes, was the very first one. But I do know that since then we've had different Spider-Men. But you know what? The thing about Tom Holland that I love about him is that he's able to take this character and make it his own. And that's why I chose that for my number two movie. I could not give it the number one place because my number one place, I stand by this movie for the whole 2021, is Sean C. What's his name? Sean C. The reason why I really like Sean C is that the relationship that he had between him and his father, the fact that this was our first, it's a first of its kind, an Asian superhero that was introduced. That's why I had to give it number one. I love the musical score in this movie. I love every touch about this movie that was made because it gives you so much of it with the backstory, but not keeping you at the movie theater for 3 and 4 hours, but it gives you the backstory. It gives you the front part. It gets into your heart and it touches you. It touches you. Sean C is a good movie. Just remember, do you remember the first time you seen Panther? You know, rest in peace, Chadwick Boseman. But the first time you seen it, how you felt when you left that movie, you felt like you were in Wakanda. And the thing about with Sean C, I feel the same way. He took me on this ride with him and I just loved it. I loved everything about Sean C. You know, I think the comic relief of Awkwafina was perfect timing. I love the action sequences, the way he was fighting. You know, I just love everything about Sean C. And with that being said, I want to thank you guys again for just listening to me, for just, you know, investing your time in me, because I didn't think that I could do this. I didn't think that I could get up here and talk about movies, even though I talk about movies all the time to everybody. But the fact that I had subscribers, you know, and I don't care how many it is. Yeah, right. But no, I don't care because I'm just happy that some people believed in me. You know, they really did. They believed in me, that they took the time to watch me. And I'm telling you, you will not be disappointed. I've learned so much since the first time I posted a video. I've learned so much about posting. I learned so much about being a YouTuber. I learned so much about editing. I've learned so much about movies that I know that this is something I really enjoy. And that is the thing about it. If you're doing something that you don't enjoy, then life is going to be just sucky. You know, who wants to suck? No, life is going to suck. I actually do enjoy this in my free time. It does kill up a lot of my free time, which is good because, you know, boredom is the devil's playground and we don't want that. So I want to wish you guys joy, peace. You think I'm about to say like in a soul, but joy and peace and prosperity as you go into 2022. And as always, I'll see you next time.